It's a chilly day here in beautiful Dubuque, Iowa, as the 8-4-2 Wartburg Knights march in to take on the undefeated Lawrence College Jayhawks for some women's soccer action. Good evening and welcome into the booth. I'm Ryan Haywood. I am once again joined by David Peters. David, welcome back to the booth. Good to have you.
It's awesome to be back here. Lawrence comes in this game ranked at number 16 in Division III and has posted 12 shutouts in their first 12 games of the season.
Let's start out with some key players to watch, especially for this Jayhawks squad that has been so good all year, and in particular, Savannah Johnson.
Yeah, she's the leading scorer for the Jayhawks. She's put up 11 goals with 4 assists this year off 54 shots. She is their difference maker, and she'll prove it today once again.
We also want to highlight Lauren Kirkle, number 41 for the Wartburg Knights. She's got 2 goals on the season, 4 assists, 8 points, and amassing 51 shots.
Yeah, by far their leading shot taker, and it's, you know, it's one of the reasons they're winning. They also are very good at spreading the ball around, too.
It certainly is. David, who's starting for the Wartburg Knights today?
Yeah, so for Wartburg, in goal, they have Tula Jensen. They have Avery Mize, Paige Leinhart, Greta Roth, Sammy Webster, Maya Anderson, Maddie Batting, Claudia Sewell, Michaela Youngblood, Lindsay Overman, and Julia Rankovich.
Kickoff is underway here in the Rock Bowl. The Knights 4-0 in ARC conference play. The Jayhawks 3-0. Again, with the season winding down, this is proving to be a very big matchup.
Yeah, this is a difference maker for who hosts the tournament at this point. Both teams are at the top of the conference.
Of course, plenty of soccer action to come for both squads in the regular season. The throw-in for the Jayhawks. Getting by, and it's a goal for the Jayhawks!
It's exactly what you wanted early on this game, a quick goal here as we are just over 30 seconds into this one.
My goodness! A hot start for the undefeated Jayhawks, and it's 1-0.
Quick start, and it's what you want every single time to come out here.
And again, that is number 17, Bella Sesniak, the 5-4 defender. Their first goal of the day. It's a very quick 1-0 lead here for the Jayhawks. Again, Laura's 12-0-0 on the season, 6-0 at home, looking to keep that streak alive. Wartburg 8-4-2, 3-2-1 on the road.
Yeah, Laura's comes into the number one defense in all Division III. They've only allowed 9 shots on goal in their 12 games played so far.
And there's the keeper, Kendall Kells, facing very few shots on the season from what you would normally see against a normal goalkeeper.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, the Jayhawks defense is very impressive. And their offense is starting to, you know, rebound from, you know, from a slower start in the beginning to playing a lot more goals in the last few games.
And your starters for the Jayhawks, of course, in net, Kendall Kells. Number 3, Christina Salerno. Number 7, Savannah Johnson. Number 8, Lauren Riggle. Number 17, the goal scored by Bella Sesniak. Number 20, Sierra Morgano. Number 22, Athena Sheets. Number 27, Kaylin Frost. Number 28, Reagan Lindsay. Number 31, Carly Weiss. As well as Isabella Russman, number 33, to round out your starters for the Jayhawks. We will see a throw-in on the sideline here from Sesniak. She throws it in. And the ball will go out near the far right side of the field.
Yeah, coming to this one, Loris is averaging 2.83 goals per game, while Wartburg is averaging 1.21. So both teams can put goals on the board.
The corner kick. In front of the net, and defended well by the Knights. And for the Knights, that's what you want.
Mm-hmm. You don't want another goal like we saw early on already.
Lindsay getting ready for another corner kick. It is up in front. It's another goal for the Duhawks.
Duhawks striking fast today.
An impressive 2-0 start for the Duhawks with 41:50 to go.
Again, just sneaks right past the defender.
Isabella Russman coming in hot. And the Duhawks are quickly up 2-0.
Just over 10 minutes in. Or just under 10 minutes in. Or 4 minutes in.
Wartburg defense looking a little shook out here as they try to get the ball out into the Loris defensive zone. Of course, this one getting kicked out by Sesniak. And the Knights will just head it in.
Loris are doing a great job keeping control of the ball.
And this is coming off of a 2-0 win for the Duhawks, taking down the crosstown rival University of Dubuque Spartans.
Yeah, it's one of the bigger games of the year, and to get that win is always awesome for the Duhawks.
And again, and they had 27 shots that entire game. Those two goals courtesy of Athena Sheets and Kaylin Frost. But back to this one, Duhawks trying to clear the ball. Knights trying to get something going, keep it in. Quickly back out. We will see Maya Anderson with the throw. Sesniak on Sewell kicks it out, and we will see Anderson once again. It's time to Webster, and great defensive play for the Duhawks. They're going to drive down the other side. There's Johnson with the header. Settled by the Duhawks.
Yeah, both of Loris' registered shots so far have gone in to the goal. So yeah, they're perfect 2-for-2 on shots today.
Yeah, heading into today, Wartburg winning 2-0, of course, against the Luther College Norse. That game played in Waverly, Iowa again. Both squads coming in here on win streaks. Sesniak with the throw in. Ball settled, and now Wartburg possession, taken away by Sesniak in front. Great defense here for the Knights. Saving kick keeps it in. And the Knights work left to right. Knights with the throw in here. Kept into the Duhawk zone and quicked away.
Yeah, Lure's doing a great job, again, keeping control of the ball and not allowing Wartburg to have any possessions early on.
And this is a team, so far on the season, has 17 goals at a goal per game. Off of 224 shots.
That's a lot of shots so far in the year. But each of those shots is distributed to somebody else. It's always nice to see where they're working together and, so you know, not just one person's taking all the shots. So it makes a good team good.
Russman kicked it away, and Reagan Lindsay will come out once again for another corner kick.
This is the third Loris corner kick of the day so far.
This is a team, the high-octane offense, as we know. Ken O'Kell's facing very little shots, and what's impressive is game in and game out. This team comes in with such high energy and just keeps it up. This one just over the net.
Very close to being the third goal of the game.
Very close. That was a header off of Savannah Johnson. The Knights trying to get some semblance of offense here as it is kicked away. They'll have to try again later on in this one.
Yeah, if you're Jensen, you got to let those two goals that went in just be in the past. You can't let them affect what happens the rest of this game.
Lindsay with the throw in to Johnson. Johnson just misses it. Quickly saved inbounds. Turned over to the Knights. A 2-on-1 here for the Knights. And the Duhawks will regroup. Sheets keeps it alive in possession for the Knights. A smart kick out by Maya Anderson. It just barely caught Athena Sheets' knees.
Just right off. And good play right there, too. Keep possession.
Anderson, another throw in here. And the Duhawks playing a little back and forth. This time out of bounds. The throw in. Misses Savannah Johnson. Kicked away by the Duhawks. Ortberg's going to head it out. And we'll see another corner kick.
Yeah, Loris atop the entire NCAA of Division III of for when Jones drawing corner kicks. And their specialty so far this year.
This is a team, David, so far this season, now 36 goals, came in today with 34, and they've limited their opponents to no goals.
It's more impressive than you think it is, because, again, they're the only team in the country in all Division III still has not lost yet. And, you know, I mean, they're the only team that has not conceded a goal in Division III, which is very hard to do.
Very hard to do. 294 shots total, and they've only allowed 30 coming into today. So, again, I talked about that offense just a little bit ago, but this defense equally is good, if not better.
Yeah, 30 shots, but only 9 have had to be saved by Kellis in the net.
Impressive.
And that's honestly way more impressive than, you know, not allowing a single goal, in my opinion. It shows the entire defense being, you know, coerced and, you know, working together.
Approaching the 33.5-minute mark in this one, the Duhawks taking over in possession. Reagan Lindsay, the free kick here. Towards the center of the field. And the Knights are going to try and clear it out. Another kick goes just to the left for Savannah Johnson. Close attempt there.
Yeah, another one nearly made it into the back of the net.
Yeah, in 12 games played thus far, 11 goals, 4 assists. Good enough for 26 points off of 54 shots. Again, Savannah being an incredible player for this Duhok team. We'll see if she can net one of her own in this one. For now, the Knights take over. Nice cross pass near the 40, kicked away back into the Duhok offensive zone and gobbled up by the Knights. We will see Lindsay once again with another far side throw in. Knights playing great on defense. Kicking it away near the 50. The Duhawks keep it in with another offensive push.
Loris consistently wins these foot races to the ball. And it's just, yeah, another very good thing that we see from the Duhawks.
Ball just out of the hair of Sesniak, and the Knights will take over. Anderson once again with another throw-in. Ball in play, kicked back out, and Sesniak with the throw. Sesniak, 12 games played, has 4 starts on the season. And a goal coming into today, 2 points. She's been a difference maker thus far.
Oh, yeah.
In this one.
See her over the place tonight.
We'll see Tola Jensen with a kick and over in to the comforts of her team as they take over. A little miscommunication there by the Knights. The Duhawks are going to take over. Towards midfield, the kick. Doesn't go anywhere. Safely kicked out by the Knights.
Yeah, the kick was blocked by the defenders right there.
Again, great defense for the Knights. Perhaps adjusting to what they have seen so far in this first half.
Seem to have rebounded from those two early goals.
Duhawks are going to head it out, and the Knights will try to get something going here. Again, still plenty of time left in this one. Duhawks keeping it in their offensive zone. Ball kicked near the 50. Kicked away to keep the pressure up. We'll let that one go, and the Wartburg Knights will try it again. Now, one thing to keep in mind here, as you're looking on your screen, the sun is settling near the south side of the field, and Kendall Kells frequently putting her hands up. We'll see what kind of impact that has here before the sun goes down. Obviously, you get a couple of shots up. Who knows?
Mm-hmm. And the ball being, you know, bright green, it makes it a lot harder to see, too, when it's this bright.
Knights trying to kick it away. And the Duhawks swarm and take over. Near the 40. The foot race won by the Duhawks. The kick to save it in to Johnson. And it is safely taken away by the Knights. Nice save by Johnson.
Yeah, most of these shots on goal have been coming from when they come up in the far sideline. Both goals were shots from that side.
We'll get a stoppage in play here. Clock still ticking with just over 27 and a half minutes left in this first half. Here's the throw in from Lindsay. Tries to find Johnson. Goes over. Kept inbounds. The nice crossover there. The shot kept away. And we'll see another corner kick. An insane amount of opportunities here for the Duohawks, and the Knights playing great defense after adjusting to the early two goals. Lindsay's going to go with the throw-in. And still a little off target on that one. Now we'll see the corner kick.
In that previous play, if the goalie didn't get there and Sydney was right there to put the shot in.
See a little bit of a screen there. The Duhawks on Jensen. Here's the kick. In front of the net. Jensen jumps out. And the ball is in for the Duhawks off a couple of nice header plays.
3 goals in 20 minutes for the Duhawks.
Teamwork makes the dream work in front of the net for the Duhawks. And let's take a look at that replay.
Played off the head right there and yeah, just headed right in. You know, Wartburg defenseman just played it right there and tough play to make. Tough play to make.
And the defender, and you could tell the direction the defender wanted the ball to go into. Obviously, it didn't go their way, resulting in Athena Sheets scoring the goal. And again, back to back games with a goal is Athena Sheets.
Yeah, 3 different goal scorers so far today.
Wartburg. Trying to get situated here. 26:15 left in this first half.
Yeah, Reagan Lindsay has an assist on all 3 goals so far.
A hat trick of assists for Lindsay. Certainly a difference maker so far, setting up a ton of great plays. A lot of great quality corner kicks and throw-ins. They look to continue that with Kells. With another booming kick near the 45. The Duhawks will win it here. Sesniak on the sideline. Looking for another throw-in. And again, there's that sun. Just peeking through behind Hennessy Hall on the campus of Loras College. Johnson kicks near the 40. And here comes Lauren Riggle. The kick is good for Lauren Riggle. And another goal for the Duhawks. 4-0.
An onslaught of goals early on here.
A great pass from Savannah Johnson, as you can see on your screen. David, thoughts?
Yeah, another foot race won by the Duhawks. We've seen it all day so far. Just beats a goalie. The outstretched goalie right there.
And the tough part, if you're Jensen, is you see Lauren walking up, running up, I should say. And once you're set and you're planted, it's hard to move from there and adjust to where the ball's at. And a great, great shot by Riggle. Just under 25 minutes left in this one. And we will see a change of possession as Kaylin Frost was brought down. Christina Salerno getting ready for another Duhawk offensive drive.
Yeah, it's tied for the second most goals the Duhawks have scored this year. They've 3 other games, they scored 4.
Duhawks trying to settle the ball. Swiftly kicked away by the Knights. We'll see Sesniak with perhaps a throw-in. Throw over to Johnson. Kicked away by the Wartburg defense. Great defense on Athena Sheets there.
Yeah, four goals and we're only 22 minutes into the game.
It's impressive. And this team coming into today was ranked number 16th in the country.
Oh, yeah, this is... this is a team built, you know, built to go far in the playoffs this year.
Sesniak to Johnson. The kick is saved by Jensen after she had bobbled the ball right in front of her, and a great diving play. Duhawks taking over, and they will call it Wartburg ball after Reagan Lindsay. It looked like she held Sammy Webster pretty good.
A little push, too. Get called every time.
Avery Mize here with the kick. Trying to spark some offense are the Knights. And the Duhawks kicking it away near the 50. Here's Johnson. Pokes it away off a Wartburg defender, and Duhawk ball once again. And here comes a couple of substitutions. So Lindsay will come out. Sheets will come out. In their place, number 26, Emerson Gassman. Number 33, Isabella Russman.
Yeah, the Duhawks haven't faced a single shot yet today, while they've put up eight shots of their own.
An incredible start here. And if you're head coach Matt Pucci, a lot of positives thus far, a ton to be proud of for this squad. But David, talk about in game situations like this, you don't want to get too comfortable no matter what.
Mm-hmm. Because we saw how quickly Gloris put these four goals. Same thing can happen on the other side. You know, in these kind of games, you don't want to, you know, kind of slow down. You want to keep everything going. Don't take your foot off the pedal quite yet.
The Knights playing a little keep back, trying to creatively pass it into their offensive zone. And they'll get a boost here with some help from the Duhawks. Ball near the 50.
Yeah, and saw an extension in the arms, and it's going to get called.
Just over 20 minutes left in the first half. If you're just joining us, the Duhawks are putting on an onslaught so far in the first half with four goals, two of them scored within the first couple of minutes, and two quick ones moments ago. So a little push there by the Knights.
Yeah, tough break for Wartburg right there.
Yeah, some of their fans not agreeing with that one. The officials strike their opinion. We will see a kick around the 25. Johnson settles in front. Gassman is tripped up there, trying to make a play to save the ball from going out of bounds, resulting in Sesniak with a throw-in. Looks like the Wartburg player is a little shaken up. It's Maya Anderson, of course. Clock stopped at 19:43.
Yeah, he's got tied up right there, and Hard to keep your balance in that situation.
The throw in for Sesniak just to the left of Jensen and kicked away by the Wartburg defense. Another throw in, headed off by Johnson in front and just to the left.
Thought that was in at first. That was slightly off.
Quality chances here for the Duhawks. Nothing to be mad at if you're a Duhawk fan. Riggle on defense, keeps it away, and the Knights will try again. We'll get a whistle. Play resumes. Nice sliding effort for the Duhawks, but they cannot keep the ball in, resulting in Jensen with another kick.
Yeah, the Duhawks defense leaves no cushion for you to make any decisions.
So we'll see Kaylin Frost come out. She is substituted by number 2, Belle Johnson, the 5'8 junior out of Wakanda, Illinois. Anderson on the near side, trying to get something going near the 40. Picked away by this Duhawk defense and kicked out of play. Anderson with another throw-in. Sesniak, another throw in. She's trying to figure out where to go. The official tells her to cool it off. Ready to go, and the ball headed near the 10, kept in by Savannah Johnson. She's going to kick it away in a foot race on the far side. And it goes out. We will see another Reagan Lindsay corner kick.
Yeah, the duo scored in the last corner kick they had.
Got a plethora of opportunities here for the Duhawks. Trying to make it rain with 16 and a half approaching. Jensen comes out and saves it herself.
A tough save to make.
It's always risky for the netminder to come out of there very far away, as we've seen so far today. Put your defense in a scramble, David.
Yeah, the tiniest of room could result in a goal being scored.
We'll have another substitution here for the Duhawks. Savannah Johnson comes out for number 11, Ellie Vahovsky. The Knights heading it out, kicked away near the 50, and a foot race for Salerno. She kicks it off a Wartburg defender, and the officials say Duhawk ball.
And heads up play to get it off of Wartburg defender right there.
Smart play, especially when you realize there's less time between you, the defender, and the ball going out. Headed out by the Knights as they settle back in defensive position. Lindsay on the far sideline, getting ready for another big throw. In the air. And headed back towards her neck of the woods. Couple substitutions here for both squads. We'll see Russman come out for number 18, Emma Casebolt. Duhawks settling with possession. Lindsay's pass in front. Saved by Jensen and scored by the Duhawks off a great rebound.
We mentioned it earlier. You come out of the net, any room could result in a goal being scored.
And quickly, it's 5-0 Duhawks. Let's take a look at the replay.
Again, bobbled by the goalie, and it's a rebound score.
And we said her name all game. Bella Sesniak with her goal there.
Her second of the night.
My goodness. Playmaker, goal scorer. What can't she do right now for this Duhawk offense?
A hat trick watch coming up.
Safe to say the Knights are searching for answers desperately.
Yeah, coming today, Loris and Wartburg were atop the conference with Simpson tied with them.
And again, Wartburg 4-0 in conference play. Loris 3-0 in conference play. Both are the top dogs in the conference with big playoff implications here, as you mentioned at the top of the broadcast.
Yeah, if this score holds and Loris comes out victorious, they will be tied, barring a Simpson loss, for the top of the conference once again.
Ball kicked out, and the Wartburg ball throw in by Kenna Hemmen. Back in the Duhawk zone, and a sliding save by Jensen, again getting risky with it once again. Turns out to be a great move there.
Yeah, the score the way it is, you've got to be riskier what saves you want to make.
7 assists for this Duhawk squad in total, 11 shots thus far off of 7 shots on goal.
Yeah, 4 different goal scorers as well.
On the far side, Hemmen in a tight race. She gets it. And a case ball on the far side. Trying to keep the ball in. She does not. We'll see Lindsay on with another throw in. And more substitutions for the Duhawks. That's number 8, Lauren Riggle, coming out. Riley Quillen, the 5'3 defender out of Algonquin, Illinois, comes in. Lindsay set up near the 25-yard line. Kick goes just to the right. Jensen saves it up. Not too much danger there. But the Duhawks eagerly trying to keep the ball in their zone. Kicked away by the Knights with just under 10.5 to go in the first half.
Yeah, this took an awkward bounce off Maya Anderson's foot. She's cannot retain the ball.
Carly Weiss comes out for the Dewhawks. The throw in. And the kick just wide of the net. And again, that was a dangerous shot chance there for Emerson Gassman. Fortunately for the Knights, it results in no goal. Salerno comes out. Sierra Johnson comes in, the 5'7 freshman out of Lombard, Illinois. The Knights come away up the far side and get a stop here for Wartburg possession.
By the best possession so far for Wartburg.
Hemmen with the kick. The Knights keeping the drive awake. Ball kick near the 20 and safely played for the Dewhawks back into the offensive zone. Perhaps a little upset are the Knights right now. A little frustrated, I will say. We've seen a couple of miscues here from the Knights on offense, trying to get some sort of semblance of offensive action. Again, here to no avail, and with another Kendall Kells kick.
Seems more on the miscommunication overall. That's a big part of this game. See, I know where your teammate's at, you know, to make that pass or, you know, make that shot.
And give credit to this Dewhawk defense. Playing great man-to-man coverage. Shall I say, woman-to-woman coverage here. Approaching 7.5 to go. Lauren Kirkle kicks it over in the middle, safely saved by Kells. Would have been a smarter move there, David, to try and get some sort of deflection, try and kick it away, even if it means knocking it back a couple of yards.
Yeah, so some sort of rebound would have been a better shot opportunity, but that was their biggest chance of the night so far.
Lindsay Overman kicks it out. Again, that was on Ellie Vahovsky on a tight foot race there.
That was Wartburg's first shot of the game.
Yeah.
That's...
Yeah. Again, for them, progress there. Hopefully something to build off of. We'll see what kind of adjustments they do end up making at half as the ball back in play.
That's an indictment on the Lawrence defense and how... A tough game they are. You just cannot get a shot off.
And we were talking about it yesterday, how the squad is still ranked 16th, despite being one of the best teams offensively, defensively, and in net with Kells.
Yeah, and again, they're the only undefeated team in Division III. And, you know, they're going for another conference title this year. And they're showing that they can pair up with anybody in the country.
The Dewhawk defense prevailing once again and kept away by the Knights. Here's another throw-in for the Dewhawks. kept inbound, kicked out. And the Duhawks will inch closer. Lindsay with another throw in. Headed closer and closer. Sesniak with another header saved. Jensen's going to quickly give it away.
Yeah, there's 4 minutes and 40 seconds remaining here in the first half. And Loris has scored five goals within the first 27 minutes of it.
The steal here by Sesniak. She's taken down near the 19-yard line, but the Knights are going to keep going.
Loris fan is not happy that he's not called a foul.
Again, plenty of Knights fans here to cheer on their squad. Back to the game. Here's Sesniak with another throw-in. Headed away by the Knights. Another substitution coming for the Duhawks. Number 29, Sierra Johnson, comes out. And it appears that Carly Weiss is back in. Sesniak throws it in just to the left of the goalpost. Here in front, the Duhawks are going to kick it away. Jensen with the ball, approaching 3 minutes to go. Strategic kick away by Lindsay, with the clock running down again. And it looks like Jensen's got flat tires. Lindsay Overman with the assist on the shoe tying.
Cannot imagine him tie your own shoe with those goldy gloves on.
It's got to be tough.
Oh,
and
yeah.
The other thing, too, is as the temperatures start taking a dive here in the next couple of days and the weeks ahead, plays a factor, too, especially
mm-hmm.
You're moving around doing all this activity, and all of a sudden your hands are frozen. Another throw in here for the Knights. Headed near the 40-yard line.
Nice.
The Duhawks will take
over. Duhawks to keep the ball in.
Sesniak, left side, thought about kicking, she didn't. Couple of great moves kicked away by Kirkle. Great defense on that play. And we'll see another throw in for Sesniak. So Reagan Lindsay comes out. Gabby Moran will come in. And the throw in near the left side. Sesniak keeps it in. The kick by Mary Claire Bean was saved by Jensen.
That was a tough save to make.
1 minute left in the first half.
Halfway that ball, like a wide receiver would.
Little tie up. The Knights win that. Kicked on the far side, and the Duhawks will take over.
That's about half a minute remaining here in the first half.
Bell Johnson throws it in. taken by Allie Stubbuck, and she cannot keep it in. Jensen, knowing time is of the essence, trying to get hopefully one more offensive drive. She kicks it. Ball now near the 40. Taken over by the Dewhawks. Kicked away. Anderson with the quick throw in. Hail Mary kick for the Dewhawks. And the first half comes to a close with a 5-0 lead for the Dewhawks. David, what are your takeaways so far?
Yeah, it was an exciting first half of the Dewhawks. And if you're Wartburg, you want to, you know, go into halftime, just talk different, you know, miscommunication was an issue. You got to go and talk about getting better communication here, heading in the second half, and, yeah, and just tying everything up here.
Tying everything up indeed. We will step aside for 15 minutes, and we will see you back here shortly. We are back for the second half of ARC Women's Soccer play. And David Peters joined along Ryan Haywood. 5-0. An astonishing scoreboard right now. And David, let's run through some of the stats. 5-0, Loris. 7 assists for the Dewhawks and 14 shots as well.
Yeah, they're really taking over on the stat sheet. Wartburg has one shot on goal compared to Loris's 9. Which is, again, a testament to the Loris defense so far. And, you know, the 5 goals, this is their highest scoring half of the year so far.
And they're looking to add more to their total. Another interesting thing to look out here, 6 fouls for the Dewhawks, 4 for the Lady Knights. Play is back here at the Rock Bowl. 45 minutes goes up. The Dewhawks will start out, swiftly taken back by the Knights. Ball rolls out of play, and Kells will get another kick here.
Loris controlled the entirety of that first half. They controlled the ball for, I would say, 90% of it, too, and I think Wartburg wants to come out here and change that the second half.
And I'm sure the Knights are going to try and make a few adjustments here for head coach Emily Ryan in her third season. So far, they are establishing great offensive possession time as the Dewhawks try and kick it away. It is kicked away by the Knights themselves. Throw in here for the Dewhawks. Kicked away. And settled near the 35. Here's Johnson. Dewhawks trying to get some front presence. As Johnson's taken down right in front of the official.
Yeah, Wartburg's 5th foul of the game.
So, play will resume, and here comes the kick. Reagan Lindsay! Her shot saved by Jensen. Here come the Knights. Moving upfield, and the Duhawks are going to kick it away. The officials signaling another foul on the Knights. Another booming kick here. Ends up back in the Duhawk defensive zone. The Knights trying to come away here. They win the foot race. Ball at midfield. Here's Johnson. Jensen is going to end up with the ball here. Kicks it to safety. And they establish possession near the 50-yard line. A couple of nice moves from Ikea Youngblood. Kicked over. Now near the 20, and Maya Anderson coughs up the ball.
So far in the second half, the Knights have been doing a good job of having prolonged drives so far.
Some nice back and forth, David.
Mm-hmm. Nobody's had an upper hand yet in this half.
So we've got time being signaled to stop. Play resumes with the Sesniak throw-in. And it's these small plays, David. Talk about how they keep inching closer with every throw-in.
Yeah, and it allows you to get down the field a lot easier. And, you know, it gives you less of a chance to turn the ball over, you know, in those situations as well.
Ball taken out. And Sesniak will march back downfield. Here's the throw. Johnson comes close up to it. Kicked away by the Knights and out of play.
Good job by the Knights to clear the ball and get, you know, and have the less of a chance to, you know, have something bad happen.
Key matchup right there. Mize on Johnson. Johnson's header goes just to the left. Jensen will come out and grab the ball and kick it back. Mize. He finds Webster. Webster kicks it over. And the Knights safely with possession. They race for the ball. Off of Maya Anderson, and the Duhawks will get another look here. Duhawks keep it in. Nice play on that one. And the Knights are back in their defensive zone, trying to push up. Batting. Back over to Lauren Kirkle. Kirkle in a tight battle prevails. Back to Kirkle off a nice play by Claudia Sewell.
The Duhawks are 18-6-8 all time against the Knights, with this matchup heading to be their 19th win over the Knights. And their most recent victory came last year in a 5-0 Loris victory.
And what do you know? It's 5-0 here with 37:50 left to go. Kirkle on Sesniak gets through, and the Duhawks are going to try and kick it away. Here's another shot, and through the uprights, not in the net. Therefore, Kells will get another kick. Duhawks trying to move upfield themselves. Kicked away by the Knights, and Mize will take it.
Yeah, so far today, the Duhawks are shooting 33% on their shots. It's a really good percentage.
Very good. Very phenomenal, this Duhawks squad. Here's a throw-in by Reagan Lindsay. Duhawks trying to kick it away. And we will see Kalen Frost taken down near the 30 and back to Duhawk possession. So let's go live now to some updated scores that we have here in the booth around the ARC. Our first matchup, Coe and Buena Vista tied at nothing with 53 minutes left. So they are at half in Cedar Rapids. Simpson and Nebraska Wesleyan have 13 minutes left in their first half. Still 0-0. Of course, these being the women's soccer scores. Back to the action here. The Knights are going to take over here with possession. They're going to try and set something up. The Duhawks playing great defense. And here come the Knights on the far sideline. Kirkle just kicks it in. And the ball now lofted near the 40.
Yeah, the Duhawks' goal once he gets, you know, by the goal in the net is to just clear the ball as far as they can and set their defense.
That one kicked out of bounds, and we'll see a throw in here by Paige Linhart. Kicked near the 50. And another kick here by the Duhawks. The Knights a little careless with their kick. Jensen's going to come out of net. She'll stop the ball.
Another risky move right here. Come this far out.
And here's a punt. Results in the offensive zone here for the Knights. A lot of back and forth action here as Kirkle is going to kick it back in. Great kicking save. And that one kicked away by Sesniak for the Duhawks. Kirkle's throw in. Kicked back out. She'll do it again. Great defense here for the Duhawks. We will see a substitution. Sesniak comes out. Awaiting the Kells kick. And it lands in Knight's possession. David, how important does it become knowledge as we approach the 32-minute mark? How important is it going to be for substitutions for both sides?
Yeah, for Wartburg, first off, you're going to want to bring people in who are going to be able to, you know, shoot the ball and, you know, focus a little bit less on defense and more so on offense to maintain, you know, because you're already down.
And another goal.
Another goal, as I'm saying that. And again, now it's even more needed. You need, you know, more offensive power coming soon.
Lauren Riggle with a goal there. And she brings the lead to 6-0.
And then for the Dewhawks, you want to focus more on defense. You already have a big lead. You want to focus on maintaining that lead and not letting it slip away in the last 30 minutes.
Let's take a look at the replay here. And just an innocent kick.
Impressive kick right there. You know, right between two defensemen.
Neither defenders could keep that one away. And the result is another goal for the Dewhawks. A landslide now in the Rock Bowl. But the Knights not giving up. Yeah, Dewhawks just killing time, David.
Yeah, both Riggle and Sizniak have two goals apiece today.
Put them both on hat-trick watch here. We'll get a whistle from the officials. So the officials signal that substitution can be made for the Dewhawks as Lauren Riggle will head to the sidelines for the Dewhawks. Replacing her is Ellie Vahovsky. Here's the throw-in for the Dewhawks. Kept in bounds. Johnson is going to kick it out. Stop near the 50.
The Dewhawks are on the doorstep of tying their highest goal scored this year, 7.
And at this rate, it looks like they'll be able to do it pretty easily. But the Knights are doing a lot better thus far, even after giving up a goal.
Yeah, you can hear a lot better communication this afternoon than did in the first half.
Knights trying to get on the board here as that one is kicked near the 50. Nice kick. And Kirkle's going to keep it in. Looked like a little bit of a push. The officials recognize that. Again, great effort, but now Dewhawk possession.
Yeah, that's a fourth foul against the Knights so far in the second half.
Starting to become a more physical game as time moves on. Some desperation, perhaps, for the Knights. Another booming kick near the 20, and a header goes out from the Dewhawks. Approaching 29 minutes left in the second half. Dewhawks keeping possession, a little bit of a whiffed kick there, saved by Johnson. And we have a foot race here, kicked out by Mize. We'll see another throw-in.
This is a perfect time of the season for the Dewhawks offense to start catching more fire. So you're winding down the last few games of the regular season, heading into the conference tournament, and in there, you know, depends on your placing at the national tournament as well.
Here's the throw-in from Lindsay. Headed away by the Knights. And kicked out of play by Russman. Looks like Jensen's going to try and safely kick it. Perhaps to Mize. Perhaps not. And she will. David, I'm kind of curious to get your thoughts on this. What would your reasoning be to keep the ball close to one of your own players versus what we see from Kendall Kells kicking it far, hopefully to the other side of the zone.
I mean, it comes down to kind of the style your coach tells you, you know, and each team has a different way they do it. And, you know, as we see, Loris clears the ball just so that their defender's a lot easier, so they don't have to be in a spot where it's harder to, you know, get in position.
And it looks like Athena Sheets taken down near the 40. Again, the physicality ramping up here.
What you're going to get late in this kind of game.
Absolutely.
You know, where
Absolutely.
You have Wartburg wanting to come and, you know, change the scoreboard rapidly. You know, Loris trying to control the ball more than they did in the first half.
And I argue that's their biggest strength in this game, is maintaining possession. Speaking of possession, it has changed to the Knights. Avery Mize takes it up to the 30, now the 40. Duhawks hot on the trails, looking to get back in their own offensive zone. Mize and Hemman tried to play kickback, and the Duhawks foil their plans. And we'll see another substitution for the Duhawks. Athena Sheets will come out of the game. Near the corner, kicked away. So Jensen once again trying to lay down a kick. Got a whistle from the officials here. Doesn't look like they were ready yet to begin play. And now they are. Here's the kick from Jensen. The Duhawks back in their offensive zone. Kick goes wide by Jensen, and she saves it.
Yeah, that little time update. We are just under 25 minutes left in this game.
More substitutions for the Duhawks, and it is Kaylin Frost coming out of the game. In her stead is Sierra Johnson, and we'll see another corner kick here for the Duhawks. Ball up middle in front of the net. And the officials will call it Wartburg possession. Jensen jumped the gun once again. Officials explaining her to take her time. Now she does. And they tell her to go back again.
If you're Warburg, it's even more frustrating just because how late into the game it is as well.
That, and I'm sure combined with the annoyance of being down.
Yeah. You know,
certainly plays a factor.
Just under 24 minutes to score 6 goals. Very, very tough to do.
We'll see, and it was a nice couple of step-and-step moves there by Sammy Webster. Now the throw-in towards the Loris sideline, taken out. And the Duhawk sideline getting loud here as Kendall Kells will step out of the game for Georgia Arhos. The 5'4 junior from Sycamore, Illinois will take over in net on the other side. Yeah. So personnel update, that is not Georgia Arhos. That is Rachel Wanless. Getting a little tough to see up here as the sun is going down here in Dubuque. Back to Duhok possession. Kick near the 20. In front near the 10. Turnaround kick stopped by the Wartburg defense. A race. Salerno is going to keep it in. And the Knights are going to head it out towards the 30. Jensen was ready to come out of her net there. And a kick here, saved by Jensen. Another nice opportunity here for Ellie Vahovsky in front. Here's Vahovsky once again. Trying to set up another play here. Kicked away by Natalie Thiesfield.
Yeah, that was the Duhawks' 20th shot of the game. Shot on goal of the game.
They've had plenty of opportunities here. Got a couple of personnel changes here for the Duhawks. Christina Salerno will come out of the game. Here's the throw-in from Lindsay. Up near. And now kicked out. Emma Casebolt trying to put some moves on. A nice defense there by Theisfeld, and the Knights will march upfield. Here comes Youngblood. And Wandless will scoop it up. And the kick up now near the 45. That was a very far kick, David.
Oh, yeah, that was a nice kick going from your goalie to clear it and, you know, and get your defense in position.
So Lindsay is near the 40 with another kick in. Goes out. Looks like Jensen's motioning some sort of a play that she is telling her teammate she's going to kick it, and she does. Nice lower kick near the 30. And Vahovsky. Nice little foot race. It is kicked away by Hemmen. Again, it looked like Hemmen was trying to set up Theisfeld for the Knights, but they do not. More substitutions made for the Duhawks. It's number 31, Carly Weiss, coming out. Now the throw in by Belle Johnson. Duhawks trying to contain possession. And Mize going to stare as that one goes out. We're going to see Lindsay Overman come out of the game for the Knights. And now a booming kick near the 30. Duhawks keep it away just for the time being. And the Knights are going to march up here. Nice crossing pass near the 30. They're going to take their time here, and here's a longer kick. Headed away by the Knights. No trouble there for Wanless.
Yeah, next up on the docket for both teams, Wartburg will face Central at home on October 19th. They'll face Simpson at home on October 26th. And they'll end out the season at Buena Vista on October 29th. And for the Duhawks, they will face, will be at Simpson on the 19th, home against Luther on the 23rd, at Coe on the 26th, and they'll cap off their season at home versus Central.
Again, the regular season winding down here for both squads. We'll get a stoppage here of play. Time still ticking away, just under 17 minutes left in this second half. Again, you mentioned, David, that the Duhawks will be playing Simpson next week. They are 9-0-3. They are on a five-game heater. They are 3-0 in conference play as well, but when they're home, 6-0-1. So very impressive there. Of course, away they're 3-0-2. See some substitutions here for the Duhawks. Number 26, Emerson Gassman, will head out.
It's another big game for the Duhawks. You're tied with them at the top of the conference, and it can really change, you know, where you're at for the tournament.
The officials will signal Loris possession once again. Here's Bell Johnson with another throw. Thrown in front, kicked away by the Knights defense. Case Bolt's going to kick it back near the 30. Fifteen minutes approaching here. Bell Johnson with another throw in. DeVito with a kick in front, saved by Jensen. Nice read on the ball, no harm done there.
The 15th save for Wartburg today.
Yeah, they faced a plethora of shots. And they'll have another throw in here. Hemman trying to find the open Knight. Now back to the 50. Hemman's going to kick it away. Duhawks trying to keep this game a 6-0 lights out victory. And here's a save by Rachel Wanless.
Nice save of the Duhawks right there.
Thankfully, no jinx there on my part. We'll take a look at the replay here. David, what do you see?
Yeah, you just see, just right off the hands of the goalie. And tough save to make. You're stretching out right there.
Again, Wanless just got it. The shot arcing from left to right. And that's a big save to keep it 6-0.
That was the biggest opportunity so far for the Knights. Their second shot on goal today. Their third shot overall.
Wanless is going to come up to the 10 and kick it out. Now near the 25. Knight's going to kick it away. And they're just going to stare down the ball now. Bahovsky looked like she was going to throw it in, but instead, Sierra Johnson's going to take it. Here's the throw-in near the 10. So the ball is kicked away. And Jensen will creep up back to position. Nice safe kick over. And here come the Knights. Both squads playing kickback now. The Duhawks play a very kickball-esque type of style. Once they do get it, and by it I do mean the ball, they do really just kick it around,
yeah.
Especially with leads, just trying to kill time, doing a great job of clock management.
You can see that right here, and when they're doing it, it's frustrating Wartburg. They're trying to get as many possessions as they can in these last, 11 minutes. And this is just kind of hindering them at that point.
Bahovsky in front. Kick saved by Jensen. The Knights just coming together, David, to try and last-ditch effort kicks and just keep it out of their net.
Yeah, if you're Wartburg, at this point, you're trying to think, how many possessions do I, how quick a possession need to be to get those 6 goals or 7 goals here in the last 10 minutes? And it's reaching that point to where it's going to be hard.
And a throwdown here by the Knights, and we're going to get a card. We'll have to take a look at replay there.
First yellow card of the day.
Now let's take a look here. Very WWE style.
Yeah, that
takedown
was
there. Sierra Johnson just absolutely thrown to the ground.
That was a tough play right there. It was warranted of a yellow card, I would think. Those are kind of plays that you can get the game out of hand real quick.
So that was number 10, Sammy Webster, for the Knights taking on that yellow card. Now here's a kick. Save made by Jensen, but she had to hop for that one. And again, coming up next, you will not want to go anywhere as the men's teams will take over. We will get the Duhawks and the Knights. Brock Booth will be in here to call that one alongside David Peters.
Yeah, that'd be a fun one to call. Two very, very solid teams coming in.
More substitutions back on the field. Just under 10 minutes to go in the second half. The throw in for the Knights goes back out of play. Sash with the throw in. Kicked back to Mize. Back to Hemmen. With that one being kicked away, the Duhawks will take over once again. Ball on the near left side. Duhawks trying to clear it off the back of a Wartburg Knight defender. Another throw in for the Duhawks. And another takedown there.
Things a little more chippy here as we wind down the second half.
Certainly so. Looked like Mize kind of just another throw now.
Yeah. If you're the Duhawks, you'll take it. It gets you better field position.
So here's the kick from Quillen. Headed away by the Knights, and the Duhawks will try to keep it over, and the Knights say no. You can hear both squads. Both sidelines very vocal today. A little bit of a battle to establish possession. And the Knights will watch it go out. Eight minutes left in the second half. Quillen kicks it out near the 20. And the officials will call foul there on the Duhawks, and the Knights will regain possession. Theisfeld trying to help her team out. And we'll get another foul here going against the Knights, and the Duhawks sideline loves it.
We've touched on it a few times, but the discrepancy between the two teams when it comes to shots is very impressive. Loris has shot the ball 20 more times than Wartburg has today.
And a lot more opportunities as well.
It's also a testament to that defense again. It's just relentless. We've seen it again in the second half so far.
Looks like the officials are signaling for time on the field. Perhaps an injured Duhawk. Hopefully she is okay. And we'll see a quick substitution here. So 6:48 goes back on the clock. We are well under the lights here. It's a beautiful night. Bit chilly here.
A little bit. Not terrible, though.
And play resumes. Duhawks going to keep the ball in play, and it rolls out. Knights playing hurry up now. And it goes back out once again. And shout out to all the ball keepers on the sideline, hustling, doing everything in this one.
Yeah, making sure no time's wasted tonight.
A little tango there of possession. Now into their offensive zone. Here come the Knights on the far sideline. And a longer kick in front is in for the Knights. Natalie Theisfeld with a goal. A nice kick to get past Wanless. So the Knights put one up on the board for them.
The first shot. Get a nice pass right there, and nice rebound by the right there to get the ball in the back of the net. It's the first goal allowed by the Duhawks all year.
And it comes from Natalie Theisfeld. Fantastic move to bob and weave through the defense there. And that's what you play for right there. You don't mm-hmm. want to go back home or scoreless back home. Again, a big goal. Duhawks, their first given up all year. And the Knights will try it again.
Yeah, the Knights want to leave with any momentum they can heading into their next game against Central on Saturday.
And again, for them, that's their homecoming. Very, very big game there. As we see a couple seconds tick down here, near 4 minutes and 40 seconds left. Here's a throw-in for the Duhawks. Knights trying to regroup. Kicked away. And the Duhawks will keep it alive. Here's a shot on goal, and it's just to the left. Nice opportunity there for Chiara DeVito. Knights at midfield, kicked away by the Duhawks. Now in their offensive zone. Here come the Knights. Kept alive. Theisfeld kicks it. And Wandless is just going to run out, make a great save.
Just snag that ball out of the air.
We got another great opportunity for the Knights late, as this one is headed back. Warper going to maintain possession here. And here comes Lauren Kirkle with a throw-in. Trying to perhaps get another goal on the board. We'll see if they do. For now, the Duhawks will kick it away. See another throw-in. Near the front and gobbled up by Wandless. Wandless with a line drive near the 50-yard line. Now kicked out, it'll be a throw-in for the Knights. Duhawks just trying to chew up as much clock time as they can. On a very successful night here in the Rock Bowl.
Yeah, they'll be reaching 13-0 to start the year with four games remaining.
Again, a big collision there. Thankfully, everybody was okay there, and the Knights take over on possession once again. Now at midfield, Theisfeld's going to kick it, headed away very quickly. And Theisfeld will chase down the ball and cannot come up with it. Now a minute left to go in this one. Duhawks can't keep the ball alive, and the Knights are going to try one more time to get something going. Mize is going to throw it over to Jensen. Jensen's going to kick it over. They've got 30 seconds left to make something happen.
Yeah, we saw in the second half, the Loras defense not miss a step. They are the same pace they were at here in the first half. And it really kind of kept them in the lead the entire game.
Another shot blocked there. Nine, eight, seven. Ball near the 50. They're going to just kick it away.
Three, two, one.
And a Hail Mary at the 50. And this one is over. A 6-1 victory here at the Rock Bowl for the Duhawks over the Wartburg Knights. The Duhawks improve to an impressive 13 wins.
Yeah, it's a domination on all fronts them today. You know, Wartburg, you know, they still have some stuff to leave they're happy with. It's got to go on the board. It's always nice in these kind of games late in there to get one across. You know, communication's a lot better. They can build up on this momentum next as they head into this next game on Saturday.
And again, they go into that game with a goal here in the Rock Bowl, and a very big goal, only because the Duhawks have never allowed one all season. But regardless, a 6-1 victory here for the Duhawks. For David Peters, I'm Ryan Haywood. Stick around. Brock Booth will be back here in the booth to call the men's side of Duhawks versus Knights.